We will continue solving deflection of this beam using the moment area method. At this time, we will determine the maximum downward deflection between A and B of this beam. Say the location of that maximum deflection is point G, wherein the distance from A to G is still unknown on the problem. Just like what we did in our previous examples, we have to follow some simple steps in order to solve for the problem. The first step is to formulate the working equation. After we formulate the working equation, we will construct the M over EI diagram. After we construct the M over EI diagram, we will solve for the properties of EI diagram. Finally, we will solve for the unknown. We will now formulate the working equation to solve for the maximum deflection between A and B of the beam. We again sketch the elastic curve of the beam. Then we will draw the tangent at point G. Since point G is the lowest point on the curve, the tangent at point G is a horizontal line. The slope of this tangent line is equal to zero. Let the deflection at point G to be delta max. That is the unknown deflection of the beam. If we will extend the tangent at point G up to the point below point A of the beam, we can have this distance in terms of deviation. We call this deviation of point A with respect to a tangent drawn at G. Since we have a point on the elastic curve at point A and a reference tangent which is drawn at point G on the elastic curve. From this illustration, it is clear that deviation of point A with respect to a tangent drawn at G is equal to delta max. But since we do not know the distance between A and G, we have to find a way on how to solve for that distance. If we try to draw the tangent at point A on the elastic curve, we can have the slope in between the tangent at point A and tangent at point G to be theta AG. From the first theorem of the moment area method, theta AG is just equal to the area of M over EI diagram between A and G of the beam. We can now say that theta A is just equal to theta AG, wherein theta A is the slope of the tangent line drawn at point A on the elastic curve. Applying the small angle theorem, we can solve for theta A in terms of deviation of point B with respect to a tangent drawn at A and the distance between A and B, that is 6 meters. We know that tangent of theta A is just equal to opposite divided by the adjacent distance. But since from the small angle theorem, tangent of theta will be equal to theta itself, since deflections are very small compared to the original length of the beam, the small angle theorem will be applicable. Tangent of theta will be equal to theta itself. Therefore, theta A is equal to deviation of point B with respect to a tangent drawn at A divided by the distance between A and B, 6 meters. After solving for theta A, we will equate the value into theta AG, from where theta AG will be solved in terms of the unknown distance x, that is the location of delta max from point A of the beam. So here is now our working equation to solve for delta max. We have to solve first for theta AG, that is area between A and G from the first theorem of moment area method. We will solve this area in terms of the unknown distance x. Then we will solve for theta A. We have to solve first for deviation of point B with respect to a tangent drawn at A. We divide by 6 and it is equal to theta A, from where deviation of point B with respect to a tangent drawn at A can be solved from the second theorem of moment area method, that is equal to area between A and B multiplied by the distance measured from the centroid of area up to point B of the M over EI diagram. If we equate theta AG into theta A, the only unknown will be the location of maximum deflection from point A or distance x. After we solve for the distance, we can solve for deviation of point A with respect to a tangent drawn at G, and that is just equal to area between A and G multiplied by the distance measured from the centroid of area up to point A of the M over EI diagram, and it is equal to delta max from our working equation. Deviation of point A with respect to a tangent drawn at G is equal to delta max. As a reminder, to formulate the working equation, we have to sketch the elastic curve, then we draw the tangents on the elastic curve that may help us to solve distances and slope of tangents. Then we will replace the slope between tangents by equivalent equations, where theorem 1 of moment area method will apply, and convert vertical distances in terms of deviation, where theorem 2 of the moment area method will apply. After we formulate the working equation, we will now solve for the support reactions of the beam. From our previous calculation, we have already obtained the value of AY and BY, and that is equal to 16.25 and 113.75 kilonewton respectively. After we solve for the support reaction, we can now draw the M over EI diagram. Just like we have explained from our previous video, Here is now the M over EI diagram of the beam from A to point B. Since from our working equation, we need deviation of point B with respect to a tangent drawn at A, so that is equal to area between A and B. The reason why we construct the area of the M over EI diagram from A to B. We need also the distance measured from the centroid of area up to point B, and that is called x bar 1b and x bar 2b. So we will also solve for those distances. We need also the area between A and G of the M over EI diagram. The reason why I select point G as my fixed reference point, I draw the equivalent cantilever. The first one is subjected by 16.25 kN reaction at point A. Here is the cantilever beam and the corresponding M over EI diagram. For the second one, I can have a cantilever beam subjected by a partial uniformly distributed load with an intensity of 20 kN per meter. The distance where it is applied is x minus 2. Since the distance from A to G is equal to x and the distance from A to C is equal to 2 meters from the given dimension. The reason why the distance from C to G is equal to x minus 2. Here is now the equivalent M over EI diagram. It consists of a second degree curve. If I will combine the two areas, here is now the equivalent M over EI diagram. I called it area 6 and area 7. The distance from point A up to point G of this M over EI diagram is unknown, that is x. The reason why all the properties of this M over EI diagram was being solved in terms of x. For the cantilever beam subjected by support reaction at point A equal to 16.25 kN, the maximum ordinate of the M over EI diagram is 16.25 multiplied by the distance between A to G, that is x. The ordinate of M over EI diagram of my cantilever beam subjected by a partial uniformly distributed load equal to the resultant, that is 20 multiplied by x minus 2, area of the uniformly distributed load multiplied by the distance measured from point G of the beam up to the location of the resultant force, that is x minus 2. Ordinate will now equal to this value, 20 multiplied by x minus 2, the resultant, multiplied by the moment arm, that is x minus 2 divided by 2. After constructing the M over EI diagram that we need in solving the problem, we can now solve for the properties of M over EI diagram. From our previous video, we have already solved for area 1 and area 2 together with x bar 1b and x bar 2b. And that is equal to 292.5 kN square for area 1, 213.33 kN square for area 2, and 2 meters for x bar 1b, 1 meter for x bar 2b. After solving for the properties of M over EI diagram, we can now solve for the unknown. We just equate the value of theta A into theta AG, from where theta A can be solved from deviation of point B with respect to a tangent drawn at A divided by 6. Deviation of point B with respect to a tangent drawn at A from the second theorem of moment area method is equal to area between A and B multiplied by the distance measured from the centroid of area up to point B. And from our previous calculation, that is equal to 371.667 kN cubic meter all over EI. If we divide by 6, that is equal to 61.94 kN meter square all over EI, and that is equal to theta A. If we equate the value of theta A into theta AG is equal to area between A and G of our M over EI diagram, just like I have explained before, that is equal to area 6 plus area 7. So we write here, theta A is equal to theta AG or area 6 plus area 7. Since area 6 is a triangular load, we can solve it from the simple equation 1 half base multiplied by height, wherein the height is equal to 16.25 multiplied by x, the maximum ordinate of M over EI diagram. We multiply it by x, the distance between A and G, then we will divide by 2. The value is equal to 16.25 x squared all over 2. And for area 7, can be solved from the simple equation 1 third of base times height, from where the maximum ordinate of the M over EI diagram is equal to height, that is 20 multiplied by x minus 2, the resultant multiplied by x minus 2 over 2, the moment arm with respect to point G. We multiply it by the distance where it is located, that is x minus 2, then we will divide by 3. Then we will equate the value of theta A into 61.94, that is what we have obtained from deviation of point B with respect to tangent drawn at A divided by 6. On the right side of the equation, we just substitute the value of area 6 together with area 7. From this equation, the only unknown is x, the distance measured from point A up to point G, or the location of maximum deflection from point A of the beam, and that is equal to 2.79 87 meters. You can enter this equation into a powerful calculator, then you can obtain for the value of x. After solving for the location of maximum deflection from point A, we can apply the second theorem of moment area method in solving deviation of point A with respect to a tangent drawn at G to obtain delta max. We will now substitute the value of x into 2.7987 meters into our M over EI diagram to solve the other properties of area 6 and area 7. After substituting the value of x into 2.7987 meters, we can now solve for the value of area 6, and that is equal to 1/2 base multiplied by height. The height is the ordinate equal to 45.479, and for the base, that is equal to 2.7987, the value of x we divide by 2. Area 6 is equal to 63.64 kilonewton meter square. For area 7, we will substitute the value of the ordinate, that is equal to 6.379 kilonewton meter, and for value where it is located is equal to 0.7987, we divide by 3 since that is a second degree curve. Then we can find for the equivalent area for area 7, that is 1.7 kilonewton meter square. For x bar 6a, that is equal to 2/3 of x, that is 2.7987, since we are finding the distance from point A up to the centroid of area 6. And if we perform the operation, 2/3 of x is equal to 1.866 meters. And for x bar 7a, that is equal to 3/4 of the distance from point C up to point G, that is equal to 0.7987. 3/4 of that distance plus the distance from point A up to point C, which is equal to 2 meters, we can find for the distance from the centroid of area 7 up to point A, and that is equal to 2.599 meters. We can now substitute the values of area 6, x bar 6a, area 7, x bar 7a, into our equation to solve for deviation of point A with respect to a tangent drawn at G. Before we will solve for deviation of point A with respect to a tangent drawn at G, we will review the sign convention applicable. If we have a point on the elastic curve wherein the reference tangent is located below that point, then deviation is positive. We can observe that the reference tangent is located below the point where deviation is to be computed for deviation of point A with respect to a tangent drawn at G, so that is a positive deviation. We can now substitute the value of area 6, x bar 6a plus area 7, x bar 7a into our equation. There's no need to write a positive sign before the equation, so we just substitute 63.641 for area 6, 1.87 for x bar 6a. For area 7, that is equal to 1.7, and for x bar 7a, that is equal to 2.599. We will insert a negative sign before we write area 2. Since area 2 is located below the neutral axis, after performing operation, we can solve for delta max equal to 114.3 kilonewton cubic meter all over EI. We have already solved this problem by the double integration method. I will provide the link on the description below. To those who are interested, you can view it for reference. I hope that you have learned a lot from this example. To those who want a copy of this file in PDF, like and subscribe. Comment down your email below and I will send it to you. Thank you.